Hi, I'm Dr. Rituja and I'm the practice owner and dentist at Dr. Nisarg Shah's The Dental Clinic in Thane. And today I'm going to speak about how what you eat affect your teeth and how it can cause dental cavities. So before I get started, I would like to share a little about my clinic. We are known for having no waiting times and we respect the time of our patients. We follow an appointment basis of our practice. So we make sure that everything is working in time and we do not keep you waiting for your dental treatment. Another important thing is that we follow an online scheduling of our appointments. So you can conveniently go ahead and do that through our Google listing page, through Facebook as well as our website. I'll add the link for that in the comments below. So what I would like to start with today is regarding your dental health. This is something quite basic, but also there are a lot of things that people don't know about it yet. There are things which people know but still don't follow. So I'm going to talk about why it's so important. So starting with point number one, that is about having green leafy vegetables more in your diet and less of starchy and sugary foods. This is not something that is only limited to children. This is also something very important for adults. And the reason behind this is having sugary food reduces the pH in the mouth, and that is, it makes the acidic environment in the mouth. This acidic environment is very conducive for spread of cavities because the acids start to erode the tooth surface gradually, and that is the first stage in getting cavities. So it's really important for that reason to focus on more of leafy vegetables and whole grains and less on sugary foods. Second point is to avoid or reduce the consumption of acidic drinks or soda such as Pepsi, Coke, Sprite, and also beverages such as tea and coffee. Although tea and coffee are mildly acidic, that is, they are just at the cutoff at about 5.5 pH, that is still acidic enough for your teeth to get damaged. With time, of course, this doesn't happen right after, you know, having it for a few months. It'll show its effects after a long period of time. However, you need to make your teeth last a lifetime, so these are important points to keep in mind. Although there are a lot of people who cannot completely stop having tea and coffee, there's a good news for them that you need to also reduce the frequency of consuming sugary drinks, because that maintains a neutral pH or a neutral environment in the mouth for a longer duration of time, which is more ideal. The third point is coming from the second point itself, and that is about frequency of having food in the day. So you need to focus on having larger meals, such as your breakfast, lunch and dinner, and less on snacking in between. Because the more you snack during the day, the more the acidic environment is going to continue in your mouth. So that's an important reason why you need to have only large meals and less of snacks. If you cannot avoid having snacks during the day, it's necessary to rinse your mouth thoroughly after every meal that you have. So what that does is it cleans the environment in the mouth and it avoids accumulation of food between your teeth or on your tooth surfaces, thereby reducing the plaque accumulation on your tooth. So these are three main points which you really need to keep in mind. The fourth point is something that you might be knowing, but it is still super important, and that is about brushing your teeth. Although we all know that we need to brush our teeth twice a day, there are a lot of people, and I'm sure that there are among you as well, who do not brush your teeth in the night as well as in the morning. There is this joke that if you want to keep your teeth, you brush at night, and if you want to keep your friends, you brush in the morning. But jokes apart, it's really necessary to brush your teeth at night because there is a lot of plaque accumulation, that is food, that's the food that you eat. It creates a tiny film or a very thin film on the surface of tooth. This is called as plaque. So this plaque buildup over time will start causing tooth decay. Basically what it is food material stuck onto your tooth surface which is going to rot over the night. So you are giving invitation for bacteria to attack your teeth. So you can avoid that completely by brushing properly before you sleep. The fifth point now actually is similar to the fourth point, and that is about flossing. I'm sure you might be knowing about flossing, but I'd still like to talk about it. And that is because there are spaces between your teeth which might not be possible to reach with the toothbrush. So that is why a floss, or it's actually a nylon thread which you place gently between your teeth and move it back and forth. This allows any material stuck between your teeth to come out. This is especially important if you have crowns or caps placed on your tooth. If you have crowded teeth, that is teeth are not in the same line or it's not aligned properly. So if your teeth are crowded, there is very little chance for your tooth to reach all the areas of your teeth which are accumulating food between them. So in such cases, it's really necessary to do flossing. Another important aspect is that if there is plaque accumulation taking place between your tooth surface or on the surface and is not cleaned properly, over time it gets calcified, it becomes hard. And in that case, what happens is it starts to affect your gums as well. And that is why you must have noticed that your front teeth might have more accumulation of food particles because it's not being cleaned properly, and the level of your gums start to go down and it begins to bleed. So that is not normal, and that really requires cleaning, or what we call as dental scaling. So these are in brief about 5 tips that you need to follow regarding your diet and habits so that you can avoid tooth decay. However, if you have more specific issues regarding your teeth, which I have not addressed here, you can definitely add them in the comments below, and I'd like to discuss about it. You can also book an appointment, and I'd love to see how I can help you get better. So hope to see you soon. Thank you.